So I know it's hard to imagine Thanksgiving without that big turkey as the centerpiece at the table. But if you're having a small family gathering this year, like I am, this is a delicious solution. And to tell you the truth, I've actually been making a couple of these over the last couple of years when I've had large family gatherings because it just turns out so well and it's so easy to make and it saves a ton of space in the oven. And this boneless Thanksgiving turkey still looks fantastic at the center of the table, don't you think? All right, so to get started, you take a stick of butter and a half cup of herbs. You can use any mixture of herbs you like, but I like to use sage and rosemary as a base because I think those are those Thanksgiving flavors you expect. And you're gonna mix that with salt and garlic powder as well as maple syrup. Get that all mixed together and then you've gotta break into that package of your turkey roast. You want to cut all the packaging off and then leave the netting in place. One of the things to keep in mind is that some of these turkey roasts either have neck bones and giblets inside or a gravy packet. So check each end and, you know, stick your fingers in there and make sure that there isn't anything hidden inside that you should not be putting in the oven. You want to wipe it dry and then you're going to take that butter and herb and maple syrup mixture. And you wanna pack it in to all the little crevices inside the turkey. And then whatever is left over, pat that nicely on top. And of course, drizzle that extra maple syrup on top as well. And then you just pop it in the oven. Oh, one more thing, of course. I like to put in an oven thermometer. Set it for 160 degrees.
And now the oven does the rest of the work, and in less than 2 hours, you can have your Thanksgiving meal on the table.
Once it comes out of the oven, just let it rest for about 10 minutes. That way it absorbs all those juices back in, and look at how beautiful it looks. You cut the netting off, and then you can slice it, add a little gravy on top if you want, and of course, you can get this recipe and many more at homewithshay.com. Shay Ryan, ABC Action News.